Hi there, welcome back to another Scriptcase Macros course video. In this video, we're looking at the SC Send Mail API macro. So my name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. So let's see what this does. So this allows you to send an email using a pre-configured email API. So you might have seen the SC Send Mail macro. This is using an API. So let's go ahead and look at the documentation for this. So we can use this for Mandrill or Amazon or just an SMTP protocol with it being pre-configured and set up. So there's some options there for Amazon or Mandrill, and you can look at how they use those. We're going to use SMTP today. So we just pass in an array of settings for this, and those settings need to include a profile if we're using that, or a set of settings if we're not using one of the pre-configured profiles on Scriptcase. And then we just going to pass through the message and any parameters relating to that subject body and all those. So here's an example of that. So we've got the profile, we've got a pre-configured profile for sending via Yahoo, and then the message parameters, so an HTML body, the to address, and the subject. Here's an option using those settings there, so not a profile, but settings. And then here's an option using Mandrill, and another one using Amazon here, and then the macroscope here if you want to see that. So yeah, let's go ahead and we're going to use this SMTP with a pre-configured profile. So we need to set that up here. So in our development environment, we're going to tools and then API. So we can set up an API profile. I've got one set up here for texting, but let's set up an email one. So I click add new, and then I add my name here, Nate Gmail. So that's going to be the name of the profile. And then the scope, so we can do public, private, or project. We're going to do public. And then here's the gateway. So SMTP, Mandrill, or Amazon for email. We're going to do SMTP. And then we need the SMTP server. So I'm going to do smtp.gmail.com, 465. And then SMTP user. So that's my username, necarpenter@gmail.com. And then I need to enter in my password. So I've got a one-time password for that, an app password set up in Gmail. So let me copy it and paste it here. And then the protocol, so you can do SSL or TLS, make sure that you have the correct port for that. You need to look at the documentation for that with Gmail or whatever email service you're using. And then the from email is going to be my email address. And then Nate Carpenter is going to be the from name, so my name. And so this should be ready, so I can click save. And now I can use that profile via that profile name, reference it with the profile name, in my control application. So here's my control application. I've got some fields set up, a subject, a to, and a message field. Let's go ahead and run this so you can see this. So there's my subject, so I can put in the subject of the email, the to address, and then my message here. And this is a WYSIWYG HTML editor here, so I can format it correctly. So now we need to go and put some code in the events. We need to put it in the onValidate success event here. I'm going to go ahead and copy this example from the documentation. That'll make it nice and easy. We could check for the API type, but we're not going to worry about that today. We're just going to send it the settings that we need here. So there we go. There's our array of settings. So the profile is going to be the name of that profile we just set up. So Nate Gmail. So let me copy that, and I can paste it right here for the profile. And then we have our message array here, the subarray. So we're sending an HTML message body. So that's going to come out of our message field right here. So MSG. So put that in the curly braces so that it pulls the value out of the field. The to is going to come from the to field, like so. And then the subject is going to come out of the subject field right there. So subj is going to be the name of that. And so now our settings are set up here. And so now we just need to run the macro. So let me go back and copy that line of code right there. So SC send mail API, copy that. So that's going to execute that macro now and send the message. So now this should be set up to work pretty much. So let's go ahead and just run this and see if it works. So click run here. And there is the subject. So I can enter in a subject. So I'm going to enter in this test email here, test API email actually. Enter in my email address, email it to myself, necarpenter@gmail.com. And then I'm going to enter in a HTML message body. So I'm going to format it just so we can prove that the HTML is working. So I'm going to make this area bold and centered. And then I'm going to go over here, take it back. So this is the regular body. So say this is a test email sent from a let me format it correctly, a SE API. And then I'm going to put that in italics, just showing some of the examples of what you can do with this WYSIWYG editor. So this is going to be converted HTML and sent to my email. So let's go ahead and see if it's sent to my email here. So I just need to go up and click on my Gmail. And there we go. So there is my email, and it is formatted just like we would expect with the different HTML options that we sent. So that's how you send an API email in Scriptcase using the SC Send Mail API.